Welcome to Session 2 of the Excel 2013 Essential Skills video course. This 5-minute preview is designed to enable you to quickly review all of the skills you're going to master in Session 2. If you already have some Excel experience, this 5-minute preview may enable you to skip over some or all of the lessons in this session. So let's start the clock ticking and begin the preview. In the first lesson, we're going to cover entering text and numbers into a worksheet. You'll begin with a blank worksheet and then add some values. And you'll learn lots of tips and tricks on how to speed up keyboard and mouse input along the way. And you'll also learn how to enter values in cells via the formula bar. In the second lesson, you'll look at the scenario where you have more than one workbook open, and you'll find a way to easily find any workbook, even if you have many open. You'll also discover how to view two workbooks at the same time using the Arrange Windows dialog. In the third lesson, you'll use Autosum to quickly calculate totals. Autosum is one of Excel's most powerful features. In this lesson, you'll also create your first formula, automatically generated by Autosum. In this case, to calculate the total sales for all branches in January, and in this case, to calculate the sales for the New York branch for the first quarter. In the fourth lesson, you'll discover smart tags. In this case, the smart tag is advising that it thinks you may have made a mistake in the formula that's entered in the cell. In the fifth lesson, you'll enter data into a range. And when data's entered inside a range, you'll learn several techniques you can use to quickly navigate to any cell within the range. In the sixth lesson, you'll begin by selecting a single column, then two rows and two columns, and finally two non-adjacent rows. That is, rows that are not side by side. In the seventh lesson, you'll select non-contiguous cell ranges. This is a contiguous cell range, and this is a non-contiguous cell range. And then you'll discover how to quickly view the average, count, minimum, maximum, and sum of all of the selected cells. In the eighth lesson, you'll auto-select a range of cells. Within this range, you'll learn how to select any row in the range, any column in the range, the entire range, or the entire range without the headers. And you'll learn how to do this with both the mouse and the keyboard. In the ninth lesson, you'll resize some rows and columns. You'll use this worksheet that has badly sized columns and then automatically size the columns so that it looks like this. In the tenth lesson, you'll use Autosum to sum a non-contiguous range. In this example, a formula has been automatically generated to calculate the sales for January and March for all branches. In the 11th lesson, you'll use Autosum to calculate averages, because Autosum isn't only for sums. You'll also use Autosum to calculate a maximum value. And here are the results of the Autosum formulas. In the 12th lesson, you'll create your own formulas from scratch. You'll create this formula that calculates 10% of the profit to pay out as a bonus. In the 13th lesson, you'll create functions using Formula Autocomplete. This is your route into the full Excel function library. And you'll also learn how to use the syntax box to quickly identify the arguments that a function needs. In the 14th lesson, you'll use Autofill for text and numeric series. You'll begin with January in a cell and use Autofill to autofill January, February and March. And then you'll go on to use Autofill to create days of the week, sequential numbers, non-sequential numbers, sequential dates and text values. In the 15th lesson, you'll use Autofill to adjust formulas. This unlocks a huge amount of power in Excel when you'll take the total sales for January and with a couple of mouse clicks calculate the correct formulas for the totals for February and March. In the 16th lesson, you'll learn how to use autofill options. And you'll work through several examples showing all of the different ways in which autofill can fill dates. In the 17th lesson, you'll learn some tricks to speed up your autofills, and you'll create a custom fill series. Just like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, you'll create a new series called North, South, East and West. And then you'll populate a range of cells using the new series. In the 18th lesson, you'll use Flash Fill, one of the most important and hugely powerful new features in Excel 2013. You'll take a full name and split it into a first name and last name. Building on this, in Lesson 19, you'll split a telephone number into its constituent parts with just a few mouse clicks, something that would have been very difficult to do in earlier versions of Excel. In the 20th lesson, we push Flash Fill even further when we use it to concatenate text, changing a badly formatted last, middle and first name into a nicely formatted full name. In the 21st lesson, we'll look at some common business problems Flash Fill can be used to solve. We'll generate initials from a full name. We'll generate a full name from a first, middle and last name and add some extra text to it. We'll create title case from mixed case. We'll remove the domain name from an email address. We'll use Flash Fill to format dates. And we'll use Flash Fill to format telephone numbers. And there's a huge number of other examples of how you can use Flash Fill to solve everyday business problems. In the 22nd lesson, we'll use the Zoom dialog to zoom a range of cells so that they fill the Excel window. In the 23rd lesson, you'll learn everything about printing out your workbooks, how to zoom the preview, move to different pages, set all the print options, and select a printer. And as with all lessons, there's a session exercise to test your understanding of the new skills you've learned. And you're now ready to begin Session 2, Doing Useful Work with Excel.